ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. صدق الله العظيم. أما بعد، all praises are due to Allah. We thank Him, we praise Him, we believe in Him, and we testify that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His hand-picked messenger who has been sent to take mankind from darkness to light and a success for him in this life and the life hereafter.
May the
mass and blessing of Allah be upon Rasulullah, his family, his followers, and whoever follows them towards righteousness until the day of Qiyamah. Amma myself and everyone to make hay while the sun shines. In other words, to do good deeds before it becomes too late. When we have the opportunity to do something good to please Allah, I'm reminding myself and everyone to do that as soon as possible before we will lose that opportunity. In other words, before our lives will be taken away. Ibadallah, I remind myself to fear Allah and everyone, as the fear of Allah, which is taqwa and piety, purifies the heart and the soul, and it causes you to succeed in the life hereafter. Like he rightly stated in the Quran, he said, and whoever fears Allah and keep his duty to him, he will make a way out for him from every difficulty that he lands himself. And he will provide him from sources he never could imagine. وَمَنْ يَتَقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. Again, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, and whoever fears Allah and keep his duty to him, he will make his matter easy for him. He will make his matter easy for him. Again, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, whoever fears Allah and keep his duty to him, he will expiate his sins and he will enlarge his reward. He will expiate his sins and his reward will be enlarged. Ibadallah, through righteousness one attains all that is good, and through disobedience one attains all that is evil. You will never come across an individual who disobeys Allah and be happy. Yet again, you will never come across an individual who obeys Allah and becomes miserable. Whoever obeys Allah will always be happy, and whoever disobeys Allah will always be miserable, or eventually be miserable in this life and the life hereafter. You might be given a small amount of enjoyment, thinking that's it. But the ultimate will be you will be miserable. No wonder Allah said to the Prophet, La yaghurrannaka taqallubu alladhina kafaru fil bilad. Mata'un qalil thumma ma'wahum jahannam. Let it not deceive you in the least. Let it not put you in doubt. People that go about on the face of this earth, disobeying Allah day in, day out, Allah said to the Prophet, do not be diverted with their worldly adornments. Because mata'un qalil is a very small enjoyment. Thumma ma'awahum jahannam. After which their final abode will be Jahannam. May Allah save us. The reward is Jannah. And he makes Jahannam a punishment for committing evil and avoiding righteousness. Again, Allah said in the Quran, as for him who gives in charity, and keep his duty to Allah, and fears Allah, and believes in al-husna, wa saddaqa bil-husna. Allah said, we will make smooth for him the path of ease. We will make smooth for him the path of goodness. But he said, but for he who is greedy, and a miser, and thinks himself sufficient, Allah said, and he believes in al-husna, he belies al-husna, Allah said, we will make smooth for him the path to evil. فَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلَ وَاسْتَغْنَى وَكَذَّبَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنْيَسِرُهُ لِلْ He will make the path to evil very easy for him. In other words, he or she will land himself in Jahannam. It is Jannah that believers will receive as a reward of their goodness and as a reward of doing good things. Allah says again in the Quran, then for him who transgressed all bounds and preferred the life of this world, verily his abode will be in Jahannam. Wa athar al hayat ad dunya fa innal jahima hiya al ma'wa. وَأَمَّا مَنْ تَغَى وَآثَرَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا فَإِنَّ الْجَحِيمَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. Whoever transgresses and he decides to choose the life of this dunya to akhirah at the expense of akhirah, at the expense of Jannah, Allah said, فَإِنَّ الْجَحِيمَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. His final abode will be Jahannam. But وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّ. He who fears that there will come a day that I will stand before my Lord among billions of human beings, among billions of jinns, among billions of angels. وَنَهَا النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. In other words, he fights his soul. Because inna nafsa la ammaratun bisoo. The soul inclined the individual to evil. So in this case, wanaha nafsa anil hawa. Preventing himself, his own desires, his lustful desires, from that which displeases Allah. Fa innal jannata hiya al ma'wa. Then for that person, Jannah will be his final abode. Allah makes righteous deeds a means of attaining all that is good. So let every Muslim, including myself, not belittle any good deed and let him be willing to do everything that is righteous whenever he has the possibility to do so. Maybe a good deed that is small will be weightiest in the scale in the eyes of Allah on the day of Qiyamah. No wonder the Prophet said, don't even underestimate giving out a date because that can save you from entering Jahannam. Again, Allah said in the Quran, as for him whose balance of good deeds will be heavy, فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَادِينُ. He said he will live a pleasant life. A pleasant life is a life of goodness in Jannah. فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَادِينُ
فهو في عيشة راضية. وأما من خفت موازينه فأمه هاوية. Do we want to know about that? وما أدراك ما هي؟ Allah said نار حامية. But it is all dependent on how heavy the good deeds are. No wonder we need to rush in order to do good. Doing more righteous deeds, even if they are small, has a great effect in the life hereafter. Again, Allah said in the Quran, surely, without doubt, Allah wrongs not even of the weight of an atom or even the size of an ant in smallness. But if there is any good done, he doubles it and gives from him a great reward. Whatever goodness we take to Allah, Allah said, I will double that goodness. Because when we deal with Allah, he does not respond in kind, because Allah is not creation. Like man bana lillahi masjidan bana Allahu lahu baytan fil jannah. If you build a house, a mosque for Allah, Allah will build a house for you in Jannah. So when you build a mosque, do you expect the same size, the same quality, the same standard for you built by Allah? No, different. You build a mosque or do good at your own standard and level, Allah responds in a different way at his own level and standard. No wonder Allah said, when you come with goodness, he will double that goodness. Now, what are the different ways of righteousness? Because it is only through righteousness that we will earn ourselves Jannah. There are many ways of righteousness and they are all easy. Because لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. Allah does not put a burden on an individual except it is something that he or she can bear. So everything that can lead you to Jannah is easy. Of course, having said that, Jannah is not meant for lazy people. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. Allah does not put a burden on an individual except it is something that he or she can bear. But having said that, Jannah is not meant for lazy people. Allah said, إن الله اشترى. He has purchased. Like the barter system of exchange. من المؤمنين أنفسهم وأموالهم بأن لهم الجنة. In return for what? Jannah. But Allah requires what? Our time, our sacrifice, our wealth, just for his sake, in a well-directed manner. Again, he said in the Quran, so compete in good deeds. The return of you all is to Allah. Allah said, compete in good deeds, because your return is to Allah. Then he will inform you about that which you used to defer. There are three categories of righteous deeds. Three, among other things. The first includes acts of worship that only benefit the person who does them, such as salah, fasting, and the like. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Fasting, the month of Ramadan, has been made compulsory upon you, as it has been made compulsory upon those that passed before you, so that you can have piety. But can I come to you and say, my friend, could you help me fast for me tomorrow? Because I have a very busy schedule. Can you fast for me? Or it's time for salah. Well, I'm in a rush. Can you pray for me after you have prayed? So there are good deeds that are fardu kifaya, of fardu ayn. No one can do for you. And of course, you have fardu kifaya, some of these good deeds which are obligatory. But then again, if a percentage of the community carries them out, then they suffice the rest. So in this case, there are obligations and deeds that the individual can only do for himself. No one can do for him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam encouraged Muslims to exert their effort in this area. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the best prayer after the obligatory one is the one which is done at night. After the five daily prayers, Abu Hurairah said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the best salah after salatul the five daily prayers is praying at night, salatul tahajjud, which is actually an obligation, which used to be an obligation upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ya ayyuhal muzammil, قم الليل إلا قليلا نصفه أو انقص منه قليلا أو زد عليه ورتل القرآن ترتيلا. It was a must upon them. ومن الليل فتحجد به نافلة. Probably your Lord, and in, of course, inshallah, your Lord will give you maqaman mahmuda. So the Prophet said the best salah after the five daily prayers is waking up at night. When everyone is asleep, then you decide to wake up. When Allah comes down to the lowest heaven, that doesn't mean he's going to climb up the stairs and come down. But that is the time when Allah is even closer to us than any other time. The last part of the night and the last part of the last part, when angel is deputed to proclaim, who is it that has a need that will ask Allah and he will respond to the need? Who is it that has wronged himself and make tawa Allah will accept? Who has anything to ask? So the best prayer at that time, kelka ñon danjelat fala jambari de rawante du ci sol mbuba bu rafet ndelay ñin soto dela bu ta ñin dam beto hanin ka ñon dang ala nya silangol to anin ala bato rijalun la tulhihim tijaratun wala bay'un an dhikrillah wa iqamis salati wa ita'iz zakah yakhafuna yawman tataqallabu fihi alqulubu wal absar. Who are men? Who are real men? Rijalun, real men are la tulhihim tijara, business, buying and selling, working 8 hours or 12 hours will never divert them. And dhikrillah, from the remembrance of Allah, from leaving everything coming to perform Juma Salah, wa iqami Salah, and establishing Salah, wa ita'i Zakah, and paying Zakah, the poor Jew. Why are they doing all this? Because yakhafuna yawman, they fear a day that when that hearts and eyes will be overturned. These are real men. إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمْعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعَ. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ, if salah has been proclaimed, when azan is made on a day like this, فَاسْعَوْا إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, rush to the remembrance of Allah and leave everything else. Allah, but this is important. But leaving everything else is better for you if you know. ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. I am so engaged. I'm going to lose this. I'm going to lose this. I'm going to lose this. Well, leaving everything for salah, then after attend to everything else, is better for you if you know. ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. And besides, when salah is over, go and do something else. فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةُ فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَاذْكُرُوا. Meanwhile, وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Remember Allah much so that you can be successful. So the best salah after the obligatory prayers is waking up at night praying. And the best fast after those of Ramadan are those performed during the month of Muharram. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. Again, he sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever prays the Fajr salah in congregation, then engages himself in devotional acts until the sun rises, and then concludes this state. He concludes this state like sitting in the masjid after the congregational prayers in devotional act with a 2-rakah prayer, Allah will give him the reward of Hajj and Umrah. You have performed salah. You left your home to perform one of the cool salats about which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man sallal bardain dakhal al jannah." Whoever performed these 2 salats, which is Asr and Maghrib, Fajr, in congregation, in the mosque for that matter, the Prophet said, you'll enter Jannah. But then he said, after performing Fajr Salah, sitting on the same posture, making Zikrullah, or engaging yourself in any form of Ibadah until the sun rises, after that perform 2 rakats, you will be rewarded for having performed Hajj and Umrah. For spending like about £5,000 to go all the way to Makkah, perform Hajj and Umrah. Having said that, that did not relieve the obligation of performing Hajj. That is the reward, the equivalence in rewards. Every day, everyone is required to give charity for every joint in his body. A two-rakah prayer in the forenoon is enough to exempt him of giving out this charity. It's the equivalent. The narration states that every joint in a person's body is a blessing. Every joint in a person's body is a blessing for which the person needs to express gratitude to Allah. And by performing two rakats, that suffices giving or paying that gratitude to Allah Azza wa Jalla, which he must express gratitude to Allah by giving charity for every joint every day. However, if a person does not have the means to be giving charity for every joint, he can just perform two rakah of salah in the forenoon. It is also narrated by Abu Darda radiallahu anhu that the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah says, when it is said Allah says, that hadith Qudsi, he said, O son of Adam, Yabnu Adam, O son of Adam, perform a four rakah prayer in the beginning of the day, and I will protect you for the rest of the day. Perform four rakah at the beginning of the day, then I will protect you for the rest of the day. You are protected. This four rakah prayer is different from the Fajr Salah, and it is an optional prayer that still brings us back to the Salatul Tahajjud. It is narrated by Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was reported to have said that no one does a prostration to Allah, but he gives him a reward and forgives his sin. Anytime your forehead is on the ground, be rest assured that if at all you're doing it only for Allah, your sins are forgiven and you will be rewarded. No action goes unrewarded in the eyes of Allah. His mercy transcends that. Abu Darda has narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam once said to his companions, shall I tell you the best righteous deeds in the sight of Allah and most likely to raise your rank in the life hereafter? Such deeds which are better than spending gold and silver in charity? And shall I tell you something that is better than fighting in the cause of Allah? The companion said, yes, Ya Rasulullah, please tell us. That is something that is better than all this. Then the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it is the remembrance of Allah, dhikrullah. Wonder Allah said, inna al-muslimina wal-muslimat, wal-mu'minina wal-mu'minat, wal-qanitina wal-qanitat, ila qawlihi ta'ala, wal-dhakirina Allah kathiran wal-dhakirat. And those who remember Allah much, male and female, a'adda Allahu lahum maghfiratan wa ajran azima. Allah has prepared for them maghfirah, forgiveness, wa ajran azima, and a great reward, which is none other than Jannah. Again, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever says 100 times, la ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lah, lahul mulku wa lahul hamd, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir, Allahu azza wa jalla will give him the reward for freeing 10 slaves. And 100 good deeds will be written in his account. 100 of his sins will be wiped out. And he will be safe from shaitan throughout that day. And no one can perform an act better than his, except the person who does the same or even more. It takes 10 minutes. La ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lah, lahul mulk wa lahul hamd, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. There is no deity worthy of worship except Allah. Wahdahu la sharika lah, him alone without a partner. Lahul mulk, to him belong the kingdom. Wa lahul hamd, to him belong all praises. Wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir, and he has power over everything. Batu mansa mantara kiri. Min batu se jongona fa. Dunia jang kata fa yawmal qiyam ala damma. Adamma killing. La sharika lah. Fula nyotal. Lahul mulk. Man sa ya batila bul. Wa lahul hamd. Tento bebe a bebe o mari man sa talare. Wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Kuo be sembo batila bul. Atele kuo be no. Amul ben bur buñ wara jamu ci dega mu nekkal ñu jëriñ adina ak alakhirah loolu dial mom ken na do te bokko ken budé nguur la mom la ñeël budé santa la mom la ñeël te mom mo am katan pour def lu ko neex fu ko neexé te du diso ken. Just by saying it 100 times, the Prophet said you'll be given 5, even one is enough. Just by saying this in 10 minutes, you have the reward for freeing 10 slaves. You have the reward of 100 good deeds written there and then after 10 minutes. 100 sins wiped out. You are protected from your greatest enemy or from our greatest enemy throughout the day. And on top of that, no one, you're guaranteed that no one can do a better job than you except the person who does the same thing unsincerely.
ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. أما بعد, it is narrated that the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever says 100 times Subhanallah wa bihamdihi in the day, no one will be better than him in the hereafter. This is in Sahih Muslim. Whoever says Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, and how long does it take again? Less than 10 minutes. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Tento be man, senya be man soye wanala tento. Sella nyal na yalla, is aksanta nyal na yalla. Allah is above, is far above imperfection. Glory be to Allah, and all praises are due to Allah. 100 times. Why are we relating the meanings as well? Because it requires to be pondered over. Not just like having 100 for the sake of 100, but concentrate. Think about what you're saying. Contemplate over the meaning. Get connected so that you don't even realize what's happening within you or within your surroundings, because you're so engaged in what you're saying, because you know what it means, because you're pondering over it and it makes more sense to you, and you get connected all the time. Subhanallah wa bihamdi. The Prophet ﷺ said, whoever says this 100 times a day, then no one will be better than him in the hereafter. The best kind of invocation is that which is said immediately after performance of this daily salah. Such invocations are a means of attaining all that is good and being protected from all that is evil. Another way of righteousness exists is in the messengers, in the saying of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he said, fast 3 days for every month. Fast 3 days every month, then you will have the reward for fasting the entire year. Because whoever does an act of good will be rewarded for doing it 10 times. If you fast 3 days the month, multiply by 10 is 30 days. So the Prophet, when he said fast 3 days every month, then you will be rewarded for fasting the whole year, is you will be rewarded after fasting a day for fasting 10 days. And of course, fasting 3 days every month means fasting 30 days every month. And that means, of course, perpetual fasting. These are all means of gaining goodness, gaining nearness to Allah, and gaining Jannah. Every little count in wanting to enter Jannah. This is the first part. Now, the second part is the second category of righteousness, which includes this and worship that involves benefit for other people. Don't only think about yourself. Don't only think about yourself. We are here today because people made sacrifice in enjoying good and preventing evil. وَلْتَكُنْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ. Let there be a group calling towards everything that's good. تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. Enjoining good and preventing evil. So don't limit it to yourself. MashaAllah, I'm doing everything and everything is okay. My family is okay. Salat is not missing. Juma is not missing. Everything is intact. We've gone for hajj back and everything. I'm not concerned about the rest now. The second act is going beyond. Going beyond. People went beyond. The Prophet went beyond. Messengers went beyond and passed on the message. That's why we're here today. And that has to continue. The Prophet will never come. Nubuwwah has ceased. But the work of prophethood continues. Enjoining good and preventing evil. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِ يُهْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Tell them, if at all they love Allah, let them follow me. Allah will love them and forgive their sins. He's all forgiving, most merciful.
This is the pathway of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ad'u ila Allah ala basiratin ana wa man ittaba'ani wa subhanallah wa ma ana min al-mushrikeen. Calling towards Allah. Just be sincere, but make sure you call towards Allah in any form that is accepted. Ana wa man ittaba'ani. This is the responsibility of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and whoever follows him. And we are all his followers. And he said, every one of you will enter Jannah except those who deny to enter Jannah. And he was asked, Ya Rasulullah, who are those who denied? He said, those who follow my sunnah are the ones who want to enter Jannah, and those who deviate from the sunnah or decides not to are the ones who denied. Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu anhu narrated that the Messenger of Allah said, there are 40 good deeds, the best of which is giving milk in charity. Whoever does any of these deeds seeking Allah's reward and believing in the Prophet's promise, then Jannah will be his abode. Again, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Jabir narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, every good deed is a charity, and among the good deeds are that you smile at others and help people when they are in need. Every good deed is a charity, according to the Prophet. Among them is smile at people. Don't frown your face for no reason. And help people when they are in need. A friend in need is a friend indeed. And of course, for the sake of Allah, being sincere. What for? You might have spent millions, but due to the fact that it wasn't sincere, it has not benefited you at all. Mere na la rek, problem am na rek. Lepp lo ma defal nga uñu yeb ne mako defal li defal ko li defal ko li amalatu la ben jeet. Abu Dharr radiyallahu anhu once asked the Messenger of Allah, he asked, Ya Rasulallah, tell me about a deed that will enable me to enter Jannah. Very important question. Abu Dharr asked the Prophet, Ya Rasulallah, tell me about a deed that will make me enter Jannah. Oh Rasulullah, tell me about a deed that will make me enter Jannah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, believe in Allah. Al-Iman billah. Abu Dharr then said, oh Rasulullah, belief requires practice to prove it. Believing in Allah requires practice to prove this Iman. Then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, you can give charity. Give sadaqah. Abu Dharr then said, oh ya Rasulullah, what if I am not that good to do such a job? What if I don't have the means to give sadaqah? Then the Messenger of Allah said to him, then you can support an oppressed person. Al-zulmu zulumatun yawm al-qiyam. Stand up against oppression. If you can give sadaqah, help someone that is being oppressed. Abu Dharr then said, Ya Rasulallah, suppose I am weak. Someone is being oppressed and I can help him. Then the Messenger of Allah said to him, you can walk for the one who is disabled. Langjurto, ki dafa tele jappaleko. Work for the one that is disabled. Abu Dharr then replied, oh ya Rasulullah, suppose I cannot do that. Then the Messenger of Allah said to him, if you do not have the means of doing that which is good, then refrain from doing what is evil. Do this, suppose I can. Do this, suppose I can. Do this, suppose I can. Then refrain from everything that is evil. Keep away from the prohibitions. Abu Dharr then replied, oh ya Rasulullah, all that you have mentioned is easy to be done. He just wanted to gather everything that he can do in order to attain goodness. If not this, this, this. So in actual fact, what Abu Dharr wanted is to know everything, then start doing all that. That's why he said at the end, all that you have told me is easy to be done. The Messenger of Allah said to him, if anyone does any of the good deeds that I mentioned while seeking, very important, while seeking only Allah's satisfaction, he will be saved on the day of Qiyamah and will attain Jannah. In Ibn Hibban. In the same regard, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said, a prostitute was forgiven by Allah because by passing a panting dog near a well and seeing that the dog was about to die of thirst, she took off her shoe and tying it with her head cover, she drew up some water for the dog. So Allah forgave her because of that, with all her evil. The evil about which Allah said, don't go near it. But Allah forgave her by giving water to what? A dog. Abu Makala alayhi salatu wasalam. Again, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, kindness with any living thing is a good deed for which one is rewarded. Kindness for any living thing is a good deed and you will be rewarded. And among all living things, the most important among them is mankind. So being kind to humanity will always go rewarded in the court of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Now the third category of righteousness is to refrain from doing evil or harm to others at all costs. The Muslim is to keep his tongue and all parts of his body from doing evil to others. In this way, he will retain the reward of his good deeds and relieve others from his evil. Allah says in the Quran, whosoever does a good deed, it is for his own self. And whosoever does evil, it is against his own self. Then your Lord, or then to your Lord, you will be made to return. Again, Allah said in the Quran, whoever does good equal to the weight of an atom or small ant, however small that is, shall see it on the day of Qiyamah. And whosoever does evil to the weight of an atom shall see it on the day of Qiyamah. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. Again, Allah said in the Quran, if you avoid the great sins which you are forbidden to do, we shall expiate from you your small sins. Leave the big ones and we will wipe out the small ones and admit you to a noble entrance, which is Jannah. Ibad Allah, let's keep our duty to Allah in the most proper way. Perform acts of worship in the way of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the way the Prophet taught us, so that we will be accepted by Allah Azza wa Jalla. Let's be aware of things that render our righteous deeds void. Things which happen when a person follows good deeds with a bad one. Beware of shaitan and his temptations. Keep in mind the advice of the Prophet when he said, indeed Allah obligated you to do some things, so do not neglect these obligations. He also set laws, so do not avoid or violate them. And forbid some things, so do not approach them. And he remained silent about other things out of his grace, so do not ask about them. Aw kama qala alayhi salatu wasalam, when Allah said, oh, you have iman, bow down and prostrate yourselves and worship your Lord and do good so that you may be successful. Again, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, fear Allah when you are he said, fear Allah azza wa jalla and follow a bad deed with a good one, then what is good will erase what is bad. Anytime you mistakenly commit a sin, let it be followed by a good one, so the good one will wipe out the bad one, and have good morality with people. Again, he said, indeed Allah does not look at your appearance or your deeds, but he looks at your heart. So brothers and sisters, let's make hay while the sun shines. Let's compete in doing good. وَسَارِئُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. God said, وَسَارِئُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ. Rush towards forgiveness. From who? مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ, from your Lord. Rush. What are we rushing for, ya Allah? Rush for Jannah. What type of Jannah? The width of which is between the heavens and the earth. وَسَارِئُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Who is it for? وَإِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. It is being prepared, being set aside. It is awaiting those who have faith. But we need to rush. This is what should be the priority. وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. And in this, let those who intend to compete before it is too late. Allah said, "Anfiqu mimma razaqnakum min qabl an ya'tiya ahadakum al-maut." Spend out of that which we have given you before the angel of death knock at your door. Fa yaqulu rabbi lawla akhartani ila ajalin qarib fa asaddaqa wa akun min as-salihin wa lan yu'akhira Allah nafsan idha ja'a ajalaha wallahu khabirun bima ta'malun. Allah said, spend before the angel of death comes. Then you start saying, Allah, please grant me respite. Give me an opportunity to go back. I want to go back to London, ya Allah. I want to visit my account again. I want to do this. Because if you give me this opportunity this time around, Ya Allah, for a sadaqa wa akun min as-salihin. I would give sadaqa and I'll be among the good people. This time around, I'll not mess about. Allah said, no. Allah will not delay the life, the soul that is meant to out, that is meant to come out when its time is due. And he's well informed of what you used to do. Allahumma ihdina fi man hadaita wa afina fi man afayta wa tawallana fi man tawallaita wa barik lana fi ma a'tayta wa qina washrif 'anna sharra ma qadayta wa innaka taqdi wa la yuqda 'alayka innaka la yudillu man walayta wa la ya'izzu man adayta barakta rabbana wa ta'alayta nastaghfiruka min kulli dhanbin wa natubu ilayka wa nu'minu bika wa natawakkalu 'alayka wa nu'minu 'alayka al-khayra kullahu ya man yujiru wa la yujaru 'alayhi ajirna min an-nar wa min khizyi an-nar min kulli 'amalin yuqarribuna ila an-nar wa adkhilna al-jannata ma al-abrar يا جبار إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا لا تدخل قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكنن من الخاسرين ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا بنا الذين امنوا ربنا انك رحيم رب اغفر لي ولوالدي ولجميع المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الله يامن والله اللهم اغفر لجميع موتى المسلمين الذين شهدوا لك بالوحدانيه ولنبيك بالرساله وماتوا على ذلك اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم وعافهم واعف عنهم واكرم نزلهم ووسع مدخلهم واغسلهم بالماء والثلج والبرد ونجهم من الذنوب والخطايا كما ينكر الثوب الابيض من الدنس وارحمنا اللهم باسمائنا ابدا ما ابقيتنا ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون. And we have our brothers who came here the last time, our Muslim brothers all the way from Birmingham. They were out and about in different localities, different masajids, spreading the word of Islam and giving da'wah. And inshallah, this week, if not next, they will finish up the 4 months that they've been going around the UK spreading the word of Deen. They're here today to join us in Salah, but they will have a final gathering with all Muslims at Wimbledon, inshallah. After the Salah is over, we can see them and take the address, and they request everyone to come and join, and it's all about the reminder of what we've just been talking about, inshallah.